Welcome to this video. Today we will show the usage of the TRACE32 sample-based profiling, also known as the TRACE32 Performance Analyzer. It is designed for sample-based profiling that collects samples periodically. The collected data can be then used to calculate, for example, the percentage of runtime used by a high-level language function, the percentage of runtime for a variable that had a certain content, or the percentage of runtime used by an operating system task. For this video, we are going to use a TRACE32 PowerView for ARM released September 2016 and a PowerDebug USB3 connected to a Kinetis board with a Cortex-M core running a FreeRTOS demo. So let's start. You can open the Performance Analyzer configuration window from the TRACE32 menu, Perf, then Perf Configuration. We have different methods that set the sample acquisition way. The snoop method allows to collect the samples while the program execution is running. The actual program counter or the data information of interest is read while the program is executing. This is called non-intrusive. This means that it has no effect on the target's runtime behavior. If the CPU can support such feature, then it is selected by default. Otherwise, it will be grayed out. In the case of the stop and go method, the target processor is stopped periodically in order to get the actual program counter or to read the data information of interest. This method is available for all processors, but it has some impact on the target's runtime behavior. Other special methods are available like busnoop, trace, or DCC. These methods are not shown in this video. You can refer to the TRACE32 documentation for more information. The mode selects the sampling object, which can be the actual program counter, the current task, the content of a memory location, or both simultaneously. I will start with an example using the snoop method. We select the mode PC to sample the actual program counter. Then we need to ARM the performance analyzer, which is per default in the disabled state. The debugger will start sampling the program counter. You can see under snoop per second the average number of collected samples per second. On the right side of the perf configuration window, you have different ways to display the profiling results. Using the list func button, you can display the percentage of runtime used by every high-level language function. Other corresponds here to the samples that could not be assigned to high-level functions. You can also display the result in a tree view. Using these buttons, you can display the result also based on memory range. You can find more details about the other display possibilities in our documentation. In a second example, I will select the mode memory and the stop and go method. Please note that in this case, it is also possible to use the snoop method since the Cortex-M supports reading the memory on runtime. In the field snoop address, I will set the address I want to sample, for example, the content of the variable mStatic1. Using snoop size, it is possible to select how many bytes should be sampled from this variable. I will finally ARM the performance analyzer to start the sampling. The perf list window will show the percentage of runtime for each memory values. The runtime shows now about 90% and the number of samples is around 30. Moreover, a red S in the debugger status line indicates that the program execution is periodically interrupted. I can set the minimum runtime that may be achieved in the runtime field. If we set this to 70%, the number of samples per second will be increased and the runtime will approach 70%. In the third example, we will select the snoop method to sample the current task. The snoop address and the snoop size fields will be automatically set by the debugger. We arm then the performance analyzer. The perf list window shows that most of the time is spent in the sieve demo task and about 0.5% in the qcost task. The two other tasks have a ratio of 0%. This actually doesn't necessarily mean that these tasks have never been executed during the sampling, but that none of the collected samples was corresponding to these tasks, so that the ratio is equal or near zero. You can find more information about the Trace32 sample-based profiling under the following links. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.